Aquarius, it's Elle here to do a quick reading. I know I have been MIA, but I have been terribly busy with other. Okay. Thank you for being here. Thank you for liking, sharing, subscribing. The old subscribers, thank you for continuously staying subscribed. Let's do a reading. We're going to focus on love. I'm going to try to get some messages about career and finance too, but we'll focus on what you guys want to focus on, and that's love, okay? So let's start pulling some cards here. I hope that everyone is well. Happy belated Thanksgiving, and I guess Merry Christmas too. I don't know. Okay, let's see. Aquarius. Okay, the situation in love for you right now is the Two of Cups. Some of you could be dealing with a water sign, maybe a Cancer. Some of you could be dealing with a Taurus also. So the relationship is mutually beneficial. For some of you, maybe the core value system between you and this other person, it's aligned. Like, you know, the relationship is mutually beneficial because your priorities, your value system is similar, if not the same. You know how you think and how you do, and, you know, you guys can just get each other on different levels. The chemistry is there. Let's see what the advice here is for you in terms of this relationship, the Hermit. All right, so could be dealing with a Virgo. There might be Virgo, the Hermit card. Okay, so though the relationship is mutually beneficial, the advice here is for you to take some time out. You've got to go on your own soul searching journey here. If there were some issues in terms of how you dealt with your own personal philosophy about relationships and love, they want you to take some time out to go, you know, go inward and start thinking about how you deal with things. What's coming to mind right now is, for some of you, it could have been some drama, some words spoken, some decisions made or needing to be made, and you need time away from this, your partner, or there is separation here. Someone even could have ghosted. Yeah, that could have been an element of ghosting you or the other person. You need a soul search in terms of why you even want this connection, what it brings to you, for you, how you feel about it. Does the good outweigh the bad? Do you know the pros and cons of this? That's what the advice is for you. Some of you may even need to speak with some expert. Go to a counselor. Go to a therapist, tarot card reading. I don't know. You need to get some insights. Some insight in terms of this relationship and yourself. More so yourself and how you're dealing in this connection, okay? All right, so if you take the advice of the cards, the outcome, Prince of Wands, so you're going to take some action here in terms of this is about movement. You know, maybe because some of you could be dealing with the Leo, Leo heavily here. Maybe your passion for the relationship will be reignited. This looks like a connection that has already started. Don't see any newness here. You might definitely take some action in terms of moving forward, moving this forward, some swift action, determined. I wouldn't say unwavering though, like you might change your mind again, but there might be some swift action in terms of moving back towards or moving toward, or yeah, see what this Prince of Wands is. Oh, this Knight of Wands. This Knight of Wands. Okay. So really good energy. Two cards popped out. We have the Fool and the Ace of Pentacles. So some of you, or maybe it's even your person, is going to take some swift action. Like someone could ask you to move in with them, or they may be, to either move in, to start over, to let's go in a new direction, let's have something foundational. This could even be an engagement, or it's like doing something, making a large purchase together. It's like doing something big to kind of solidify the relationship here. Like, it's either you or the other person doing this. Let's see what your person wants to tell you, Aquarius. What does Aquarius person want to tell you? Eight of Wands. All right, so things are going to move rather quickly in your love life. Your person, you know, may be saying, let's have a conversation about the drama and the problems and the jealousy and maybe even the greed that happened or is happening between us. Let's see if we can come to some common ground. Or your person maybe just giving you loving communication back and forth. But this is a clearing of the air. Some of you, if this is moving in together, some of you are going to have conversation about finances, about the merger. How do we come together? You may even talk about, the other person's finances, investments. You may get into some very intimate conversation here. So this is what your person wants. Also, they may want to have sex with you if they have not, or if you guys are not having sex, that may be a topic that is brought up also. Now, what else your person wants to tell you? Okay. Ten of Swords. Okay. So they want to tell you that they want the bad times to be over. They want the disappointing, the discouraging, the hurtful times to be over. Some of you, they're telling you that their ego, not even their ego, but their reputation, something of that sort was damaged or is damaged. This is a masculine energy here. And this could be you, Aquarius. But they may be telling you that, somebody said something that kind of put this person in a place of, for this disappointment in their career, with their reputation, with the success of things. They may be saying, let's clear the air so that we can really be done with the disappointing times that we both have shared in. This is what they're saying to you. That they want this hurtful time, this discouraging time, to be over. Okay, what else does this person want to tell Aquarius? The Three of Cups, they want to reconcile. They may even be telling you that they're done with the third party. They want to celebrate. They want to have more loving, emotional communication toward you. Something about a sibling or siblings, something about a friend group, social activities that they were engaged in. They could be telling you that they put some other activities down because they knew it wasn't conducive to you guys having a successful connection. Okay, so they want to, let's see, what is this Three of Cups? Because I hate to get the Three of Cups and it's not, I don't know. What is the Three of Cups? Now the cards don't want to talk now. When I ask, what is the Three of Cups? Okay, and then they all fall on the floor. Okay, all right. So let's see. The Ten of Wands. I saw the Ten of Wands didn't come out, but it just showed its head. So this person really wants the fate, the destiny, the fortune of this relationship to shift, to change. They want the connection to be better. They want to lay down some burden that they were carrying. This person may have been stretching themselves so thin, putting more energy, effort, time into other people, social activities, other women, other men, family, work, and had no time or very little time for you. They could have been holding a secret that there was a third party. So, let's see. Oh, it was the Three of Cups. Yeah, the Magician. Okay, so instant manifestation. You know, if you play your cards right. I'm hearing that song. If you play your cards right, everything's going to be all right. Yeah, so this person is telling you that, look, they want to do the right thing. They want to make this happen. Like, they see that they have all the tools necessary in their lives within them to actually bring about what it is they want for your connection. This person is using their words with the Three of Cups and the Magician, very much using their words to get their desired outcome. This card talks about, all I keep hearing is words, 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 words. They're really, we got a card that fell. They're really saying a lot in order to get you to come back. Yeah, okay. And the Emperor just fell out of the deck. Some of you could be dealing with a gentleman who's older than you. I can't say that's a woman. I know some readers like to say, there's no gender in the tarot. And there really isn't. You know, if we were pulling cards in terms of how is this person's personality or how do you see them? Yeah, okay, there's no gender, but this is a gender. This is a man. This is a grown man. This person could be saying that, look, they're trying to pull themselves together, use everything that they have in terms of their resources and being resourceful so that they can be the man that you need. The man, this could be a committed man too. This could be somebody who's already has someone, but it looks like they're on the brink of trying to let this person go. I do not see it absolutely that they're letting this person go right now, but they're on the brink of letting something go, a lifestyle go. I don't know. Let's go ahead and get an outcome for Aquarius. That did not come out. What? I'm so happy a shuffle on camera because you guys would have said, oh, she made that up. Okay. The outcome for Aquarius, and then I'll hold this one up too, is the Six of Wands and the Empress. And you also have your Emperor. Wow. All right, so look, Aquarius, you're going to get what you want or what is best desirable. Or whatever it is you desire, it's going to come to you. You're going to get a lot of recognition. This card, the Six of Wands, used to be called the Proposal. So you could get a proposal. If someone is exalting you in all of your splendor and all of your glory, someone understands that in the connection with you, it is healthy. It fits in their life. Once again, back to the Two of Cups. The core values, they match here. This could be you saying this about someone else or vice versa, or it's mutual. Could be dealing with the Leo once again here. Libra, Taurus coming up heavy again. It looks like you get exactly what you want. You get growth and fertility in your love sector because we pull cards for love. We get Eight of Cups. We get someone returning to you. You know, if this is happening right now, the Hermit card, you guys are separated. So this is really good. We get a person, they're contemplating before making a decision here with the Four of Swords. A huge decision, right? Very nice energy for the Aquarius. I'm going to leave you with some Moonology cards, but also we're going to do an extended. We're going to ask the question of what is hindering the relationship? Why is it being held up? What can Aquarius do in the interim and right now while waiting for this relationship, situationship, whatever it may be? What can Aquarius do? What's their best advice right now? And what's the outcome if Aquarius takes the advice, okay? All right. So follow me over if you want to get the extended. It looks really good for you, but we want to see what's holding up the energy. Why is the Hermit card here? Why are you guys separated? What's going on? Is there anything that Aquarius can do to move this forward? All right, so Moonology cards. You know, today is the full moon. Full moon is for expelling. Expelling that energy, those things that you want out of your life. Okay? All right, so think about, make a list today of things you want to get rid of. Go out in that full moon tonight, wherever you are. You can bury your list. You can burn it. You can pray over it. Whatever you want to do. Find a ritual that is best for you. Okay? All right. Moonology for Aquarius. Aquarius, it also looks good in terms of career and finance. It looks like you'll be doing something new. You're going in a new direction in your career. And we have a new moon in Cancer coming up, or full moon in Cancer coming up. It says that you and your loved ones are safe. New moon again. So some of you are definitely dealing with the Cancer crab. Some of you are a little confused or you had to take a step back because someone is or was coming at you sideways and not directly. So you couldn't figure things out. Or you want the words to be spoken. And someone is trying to come at you with sideways actions. All right. Last card for the Moonology. And then meet me over in the extended. Wow, Aquarius, your hard work is paying off. New Moon in Capricorn. Very, very, very nice. We've got Capricorn season coming up for you. Your hard work is paying off, Aquarius. Very excited for you. Follow me over to the extended where we talk about what is hindering this relationship, what can Aquarius do in the meantime, and what's the outcome if Aquarius takes the advice of the cards, okay? All right, so thank you. Take care, guys.